this video, we're going to look at the simplicity and versatility of the breakfast burrito. Breakfast burritos are really a great thing. They contain vegetables and can be served with a salsa on the side. You have your eggs, possibly cheese or sausage if you wish, and they are all contained in a whole grain wrap. So you just toss in a milk and you have yourself a complete meal. They are great and travel well for kids that are eating in the classrooms, and they are also a wonderful option for students working remotely because they can be reheated so easily. So the first thing you're going to want to do is gather up all of your ingredients and tools that you're going to need to make your burritos. I have whole wheat wraps. These are the 8-inch size, so it's just like the USDA ones that you receive in your schools. I have liquid eggs here, 2.5 cups. If you're using shell eggs that you're going to mix up by hand, the rule of thumb is 1 large egg per 1/4 cup, so you would need 10 large eggs. I have 10 ounces of shredded cheddar cheese here. You can use whatever kind of cheese your students prefer, and it's a great way to use up your USDA cheeses. Here I have 1.5 cups of chopped up onions and 1.5 cups of chopped up green peppers. I have salsa, and I have a 4-ounce cup that I'm going to be portioning my salsa into. This way I can ensure that I at least get 1/4 cup. Sometimes if you use the 1/4 cup, it almost overfills and it's hard to get the lid on. If you don't have time to cup up your own salsa, Red Gold makes a great salsa cup that you can use your NOI pounds for as well if you have allocated them to Red Gold. You're going to want, for this size batch, I'm going to use a large skillet with a heat-proof rubber spatula and, of course, some pan spray so things don't stick. If you're going to be doing a large quantity of these in your school, if you have either a flat top, that would work wonderfully, or a tilt skillet would work great for this as well. You can also choose to either cook your onions and peppers off ahead of time or not. That is completely up to you. Because I am doing such a small batch today, I'm going to go ahead and cook mine off. So in this kitchen here, we have an induction burner. So that is what I'm going to be using. But just make sure that you're familiar with how your burners in your school work. You know how fast they heat up, things like that. Just to make sure that you don't overcook your food items. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this on and put it up to about medium heat because I don't want to cook my peppers and onions too quickly. I'm at about 50% heat right now, and I'm going to go ahead and spray my pan so that things don't stick when I do add them in. Now, once your pan has started to get hot, you go ahead and add your peppers and onions. So I'm going to continuously stir these so that they don't get too browned up, but I do want to soften them. All right, now that we have a little bit of color, let's see if I can tip that up so you can see a little bit, on our peppers and onions, I'm going to go ahead and pour in our eggs. So, of course, with eggs, it is not going to take long for these to scramble up. You want to make sure when you're doing scrambled eggs, you keep it moving, otherwise you'll end up with really extra browned bits on the bottom. All right. Once my eggs are just about fully cooked, I'm going to go ahead and shut off the heat. There we go. And I'm going to spread these out throughout the pan here. And I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle my cheese on top and allow it to melt using the heat of the eggs and the peppers that are already in there. So then while that is melting, I'm going to go ahead and set that right over here to the side. The next thing I want to do, because now I'm technically handling ready-to-eat food, is get a pair of gloves, and I'll go wash my hands and then put them on to start preparing the burrito. So now that my hands are clean, I'm going to go ahead and put my gloves on. And I'm going to open up my package of tortillas. Now, if you find that you maybe struggle to wrap up the burritos because the tortillas might crack or break, One thing you can do is actually pop them into either a warmer if you have it, or your oven turned on a very low temperature. This will just kind of soften them up a little bit. You will not want to leave them in there very long, because what can happen is if they get overheated, when they cool down, they can get very hard. So when you're going to be assembling a lot of things like this, I like to actually form an assembly line. So I have my ingredients here. I'm going to lay out my tortillas. And because I have 10 of them, I'm going to kind of try and arrange it in a way that's easy to work with. I have 10 tortilla shells laid out here. So then I can see that my cheese is starting to melt. I'm going to go ahead and just give this a good mix to get it fully melting through. So the next thing I'm going to actually get is a grain handle or half cup portion control disher, and I'm going to use that to portion out my fill in here. So dishers really are a great tool. They help you become extremely consistent with the portion control sizes in your school kitchens. So now that I can see that my cheese is pretty much mostly melted, I'm going to go ahead and start portioning this out, one scoop into each burrito here. If you have a little bit extra, that's okay. I would just spread it out amongst all of the burritos that you have here. If you see one that you might have short scooped, things like that, that's really kind of where you'd want to focus first. That one looks a little lower than this one up here does to me. All right, so the next thing we're going to want to do is actually wrap them up. I'm going to go ahead and remove this pan from the table here. Now, if you are going to be wrapping these up for immediate service, I highly recommend using foil wrappers. It will help to hold in the heat. But if you're going to be wrapping them to freeze and serve, send home to your remote students, I would then do it with plastic wrap. Some younger children might not realize that it's not okay to put foil in a microwave, and you can go right into a microwave with something that's wrapped in plastic wrap, and it'll heat wonderfully. So I have some plastic wrap here. And I'm going to go ahead and cut off a small piece. And when I wrap burritos, I tend to go in from the side first and then fold over, tuck it up in there, and continue to close it up. And then what I would do is take your plastic wrap and just roll it up and pull your sides over, and you have a wonderful sealed breakfast burrito. Now, I also have some foil wrappers over here, just to show you how easy those can be as well. But they pop right out of the box. And just like with the plastic wrap, you want to wrap the burrito itself the same exact way, right onto the foil. And nice and snug, and you can actually put this in a warmer just like this so it's ready for service. Now all you would need is that cup of salsa and a milk, and your student has a complete meal.